वेदसार शिवस्तोत्रम्। पशूनां पतिं पापनाशं परेशं गजेन्द्रस्य कृत्तिं वसानं वरेण्यं जटाजूटमध्ये स्फुरद्गांगवारिं महादेवमेकं स्मरामि स्मरारिम्। महेशं सुरेशं सुरारातिनाशं विभुं वेश्वनाथं विभूत्यंगभूषं विरूपाक्षमिन्द्वर्कवन्नी त्रिनेत्रं सदानंदमीडे प्रभुं पंचवक्त्रम्। गिरीशं गणेशं गले नीलवर्णं गवेन्द्रादिरूढं गुणातीतरूपं भवं भास्वरं भस्मनाभूषितांगं भवानीकलत्रं भजे पंचवक्त्रम्। शिवाकांत शंभो शशांकार्धमौले महेशानशूलिन् जटाजूटधारिन् त्वमेको जगत्व्यापको विश्वरूप प्रसीद प्रसीद प्रभो पूर्णरूप। परात्मानमेकं जगद्बीजमाद्यं निरीहं निराकार ओंकार वेद्यं यतो जायते पाल्यते येन विश्वं तमीशं भजे लीयते यत् विश्वम्। न भूमिर्न चापो न वह्निर्न वायुः न चाकाशमास्ते न तन्द्रा न निद्रा न चोष्णं न शीतं न देशो न वेशो न यस्यास्ति मूर्तिस्त्रिमूर्तिं तमीडे। अजं शाश्वतं कारणं कारणानां शिवं केवलं भासकं भासकानां तुरीयं तमः पारमाद्यन्तहीनं प्रपद्ये परं पावनं द्वैतहीनम्। नमस्ते नमस्ते विभो विश्वमूर्ते नमस्ते नमस्ते चिदानंदमूर्ते नमस्ते नमस्ते तपोयोगगम्य नमस्ते नमस्ते श्रुतिज्ञानगम्य। प्रभो शूलपाणे विभो विश्वनाथ महादेव शंभो महेश त्रिनेत्र शिवाकांत शांत स्मरारे पुरारे त्वदन्यो वरेण्यो न मान्यो न गण्यः। शंभो महेश करुणामय शूलपाणे गौरी पते पशुपाशनाशिन् काशीपते करुणया जगदेतदेकः त्वं हंसि पासि विदधासि महेश्वरोऽसि। त्वत्तो जगद्भवति देवभवस्मरारे त्वय्येव तिष्ठति जगन्मृड विश्वनाथ त्वय्येव गच्छति लयं जगदेतदीश लिंगात्मके हरचराचर विश्वरूपिन् लिंगात्मके हरचराचर विश्वरूपिन्। इति वेदसार शिवस्तोत्रम्। श्री गणेशाय नमः। ओम श्री सरस्वत्यै नमः। ओम श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः। ओम समस्त जन कल्याणे निरतं करुणामयं नमामि चिन्मयं देवं सद्गुरुं ब्रह्मविद्वरम्। ओम श्रुति स्मृति पुराणानां आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पाद शंकरं लोकशंकरं। ओम कर्पूर गौरम करुणावतारम संसार सारम भुजगेन्द्रहारम सदा वसंतम हृदयारविंदे भवम भवानी सहितम नमामि। हरि ओम। महेशम सुरेशम सुराराति नाशम ईडे। आई प्रेज I sing the glory of the Lord who is Mahesha, the God of gods, Suresha, also he is the Lord of all the devatas, Surarati Nasham, the destroyer of the foes and the enemies of the devatas. I also read one reading, Surarati Nasham. If you say Surarati, then the meaning will be the destroyer of the afflictions, distress, sorrows of the devatas. If you say Arati, then the meaning is enemies of that. See, outside enemies are there, they also cause lot of distress, and we have many wonderful in our own mind, which also cause lot of distress. Bhagavan is destroyer of them. In other words, he makes us happy. Mahesham, Suresham, Surarati Nasham, Vibhum, Vishwanatham, Vibhutyanga Bhusham, Vibhu. This word is sometimes translated as all pervading. It also translated as vividham bhu bhavati. Vividham bhavati iti vibhu. The one who becomes many, appears in countless forms, because he is the very source of the whole creation. And we know that even a little area also, if you see the vividhata that you will see, it is mind-boggling or not. Only one see tree, if you just see the little flowers, see their design and their color and all that. And if you see all the whole creation, भगवान अलोन इज अपियरिंग इन ऑल दिस फॉर्म बिकॉज ही इज द सोर्स ऑफ द होल क्रिएशन. विविधम भवती एंड ऑल्सो इज ऑल परवेडी अपियर्स एज मेनी. बट द क्वेश्चन इज ही लॉर्ड ऑफ द होल वर्ल्ड इज ए विश्वनाथम. See, in this world what we find, a man and woman, they get married, then they have children. Who are these children? These parents only in the different form, these children are there or not? Yes. But already the nath of children, do they listen? They are only, after all, who is appearing in that form? So anyway, I don't want to go on telling. We start what you call an industry and employ so many people and all that, but we don't become really lord of all of them. But Bhagwan is Vibhu and also Vishwanath. He is the lord of the whole universe. Now Vishwa, the meaning of the word Vishwa is Vividham Shvayate Iti Vishwam. Generally we say universe, the world. And we have got a peculiar idea, this our the world is very static. Because you see the whole mountain, one place and all that. But it means Vividham Shvayate Iti, which moves in many ways. And that's why we see nothing remains the same. Because if it was static, there is no change in all that, nothing would have changed also. So therefore, he is the lord of that universe, which is very dynamic. So he is the source, he alone appears in all these forms, and remains the lord of all. The whole world moves in many, many ways. That is called Vibhum, Vishwanatha. Vibhuti Angabhusham. Again you see V. See? Vibhum Vishwanatham Vibhutyangabhusham. Again Anuprasa. See again V. Alliteration. Vibhum Vishwanatham Vibhutyangabhusham. His Anga, his whole body, the limbs. Bhusham means it is adorned. Adorned with what? Vibhuti. Vibhuti? Yeah. You know, Bhagavan applies ashes. In the next look also there is about Bhasma, then we'll see more of it. So Vibhuti is the body, the limbs of his body, they are adorned with the ashes, that is called as Vibhuti. But the Vibhuti word is used in the meaning of glory, Aishwarya. So this Vibhuti word stands for Aishwarya. In the Bhagavad Gita also in the 10th chapter, what is called Vibhuti Yoga. Bhagavan's Vibhuti is all there. It is not an ordinary kind of ash that is just applied here. That is Aishwarya Darshak. His lordship, his prowess, his might, his riches, his glories, everything is indicated by that Vibhuti. Okay. Vibhum Vishwanatham Vibhutyanga Bhusham. Virupaksham. Virupaksham Indu Arka Vandhi Trinetram. Now Virupaksham, Aksham is eyes. Now suppose you say Rupaksham, then you say beautiful eyes. Virupa means not beautiful, unpleasant. What do you mean by that? You see, idea is like this. Ordinary when we see a person, the two eyes are there, so we say it is nice, you know. But suppose you see a person, you got one eye more here. How it will look? Everybody start looking at him. What happened? Some kind of freak. Strange, you know. So here this Virupaksha, another stotra which Shankaracharya has written, in this, in which he says Vishamaksha. Sama means equal. Even number is called sama. Odd number is called Vishama. So like 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, they are called odd numbers. 2, 4, 6, they are called even numbers. So generally when you see a person who has got two eyes, now you have got two hands. Suppose you see one more hand is coming somewhere, so it will look little ugly. So it will not be very pleasant. No, Bhagavan has got three eyes. What is the Virupaksham? So it is, cannot be called as ugly, but Vishesha. Bhagavan, for him, everything is Vishesha then. Not Kurupata, but Visheshurupta. It is something very unique. That's called unique. What is uniqueness? He has odd number of eyes. And that's called Trinetram, immediately explained. Trinetram. That is called Virupaksha. So, Bhagavan Shiva has got three eyes. Yes. And what are those three eyes? Trivirupaksham, Indu, Arka, Vanni, Trinetram. These three netras are, Indu means the moon, Arka is sun, and Vanni means fire. I think everything is very peculiar, sir. That means the power of in each eyes is not the same. One eye too powerful, the other will dull. We should not take this kind of meaning. When we say the sun and the moon and the fire, they are the three eyes of Bhagavan. Now see, what is the common factor in all the three? One is called a prakash. Light is their common. Fire has light, moon has light, sun also has light. And that light only illuminates this world. Light is that which illuminates the world. So he illuminates the world with these three eyes. Now, second thing is what we find, even though the light is a common factor, but each of them has got a very special feature and quality, isn't it? In fire, the dahakta, it burns, reduces that thing to ashes then, dahakta. So, prakash is there. But such ushnata is there which burns. Even little spark of fire also, it will fall on your body immediately. But you see sun's light and that is falling on our body, are we burning like that? No. So sun's light is bright. It is not dahak like fire. When it is too hot and all that, you may get too much of heat or heat stroke like something like, but not burning like fire. So this light of the sun is bright, brilliant. Ugra it is also, tej. But not like fire. Only if you gather those rays, you know, with a lens and all that, then it is a different thing. Otherwise, normally when it is there, there is no problem. But when you think of moon, Sheetal Prakash. Right? That's why at moon, you know, you can go on looking at that moon for hours together. But you cannot go on looking at the sun like that. Huh? And this moon's rays also fall on us, Sheetala Kirana. So what we find, in the moon there is a Sheetalta, coolness. in the sun brightness, and in the fire dahakta, burning quality. Right. So now what is the meaning? Bhagavan has got three netra. And I will tell you, we all have got three netras. What? That I will tell you. The question is, how you look at this world? That is important. If someone is in distress and sorrow and comes, and then Bhagavan looks at that person with his Chandra Roop eyes, cool, then Bhagavan's glance is very, very pleasing, consoling. Then when he wants to give some knowledge and all that, bright. So we say, no, it became clear to me like daylight. I was in darkness, you know, I just did not know. And one by one subjects, how long I will just know, right? See, if in the light and darkness, if you are just walking somewhere, then we have got a flashlight. And only that goes on illuminating little path. But the moment there is sunlight, it illuminates the whole world immediately. That means what? Bhagavan gives that knowledge in an instant. Don't we say the student is bright? Bright student. Why? Because his capacity of understanding is bright. The teacher who can teach that way is a brilliant teacher. Right? And then fire. Fire will burn. Right? It is said, you know, when that Kamadeva came to disturb Bhagavan, Tapas, and Bhagavan looked at Jnana, Agni, but he was reduced to ashes. Now, as I mentioned to you, we also have got these three eyes. That means three ways of looking at people. That's why in our Indian trucks also it is written, Dekho magar pyar se. I want to read that because, you know, the truck is going and the other man and wants to pass and that man doesn't give the way and all that. Then after some time when he gives the sight, then this man, zoo, and already tendency to, who is that driver? So he say, Agni drishti se mat dekho mere ko, Chandra drishti se dekho. Don't look at me with a fierce eyes. See, when we are angry, how we look at somebody? Dakshati wo. It's called jala dalega usko bilkul. He will burn him. But when we love, pyar. So we have got moon eyes. And you have to teach someone. Come, I will teach you. Come. Our Gurudev was fond of watching tennis. He himself was a good player. So at one place in US, you know, he was watching. I never understood anything. But I went and sat there. He asked me, do you understand? I said, no. I will tell you. He got so excited. I will tell you what it is. Well, that was Surya. Oh, you don't know this game. So when you are enlightening someone, then that's called the eye of the sun. When you are loving, pleasing, consoling, assuring, reassuring, Then they are called Chandra Drishti. But your anger and all that, then when you look at that, is the Fire Drishti. Fire. You have all this. If I have, you also must be having. So, these are the three eyes. Surya, Chandra, Agni. Point is, he is the illuminator of the whole world. And what is to be burned, then the Agni Drishti is there. And then Surya Drishti, Chandra Drishti. Okay, that is called Trinetram. Now we will see some other meaning also. See, Bhagwan is Karma Phala Data. He is the giver of the fruits of actions. So that means what? He has to do justice. He is a Nyayadish. And do you know, the justice, a judge, also must have three eyes. What is the meaning? One is the objectivity. Nyaya Drishti is called Nyaya, justice. So while giving his verdict, whatever punishment, this, that, according to Nyaya only had to do that, according to the law, justice. But see, if all the time that person says, according to the law, the letter of this other, I am going to punish you and like that, there is no compassion at all, then that justice can become very, very harsh. Only if you go by justice. So, Nyaya is one eye. Second is Karuna. There has to be compassion also. See, if only compassion is there, okay, forgiven, acquitted, then there will be anarchy, there will be no rule at all. And only justice, then it will become very harsh and cruel. So the person has to know how much punishment should be given, how much compassion should be there, so that the rule of the law also prevails, and also the crime rate also reduces, right? And therefore now, many times you see now the jail, that word jail is being changed to correction. That's called correction cells and all that, right? Why? But I tell you, for that Viveka is required. Therefore, third drishti, jnana drishti, to understand the difference. So when we say Chandra, Surya, Agni, Bhagwan's eyes, they are illumining everything. And Bhagwan looks at everyone, the whole world. Since he is a karma phala data, dispenser of the fruits of action, that has to follow justice, compassion, with discretion, knowledge. So three eyes. Again and again I tell you, in our own life also, we have to do all these things. Smaller scale, bigger scale, and all that, you know. So there also we have to have the drishti. Virupaksham. So it is, we should have unique eyes. Bhagavan is the one who has got unique eyes. Generally people have got two, but he has got three. Virupaksham, Indu arka. Vanhi fire, Trinetram. Sadananda Mide Prabhum Panchavaktram. So I praise that Prabhu, Prabhavati, it is Prabhu. Prabhu with a great lord of great influence. An influential person is called Prabhu. Sarva samarthaha, all capable. When you say all capable means, it is defined as kartum, akartum, anyatha kartum, shaktaha. The one who can do, undo, otherwise do, that everyone doesn't have that type of ability. Mm-hmm. But this Bhagavan is Prabhu. And Sadananda, Sadananda word can be split as in this way, Sat plus Ananda, the one who is of the nature of pure existence, immortal, eternal, Ananda, and his Ananda Swarupa. Or Sadananda means ever blissful. And what is the condition of Jivas? Don't talk about Jivas, you know. So you ask one jiva, Bhaiya, what is your name? What is my name? Anananda, Nirananda. No ananda at all in my life. Joyless. Acha Bhaiya, what about you, second person? Kadananda, always waiting when I will get joy. Kada anandaha bhavati. Third, what about you? Yada kadananda. Now and then happy means what? Vishayanam anukulle sukhi dukhi viparyaye. When all objects, things, beings, situations around me are according to my desire, what I like, then I am happy. But when they are not, and generally they are not, because one thing is there, second thing is not there. So full ananda is not there, you know. That's why I say, yada kada ananda. I tell you, only those men of realization who have realized this Shiva Bhagavan as their own self, they are also Sadananda. And Bhagavan is of course Sadananda. Because Ananda does not depend upon anything. He is, and he is Ananda. That's called Sadananda Mide. He only is called Chidananda. He is only called Satchidananda. Sadananda Mide Prabhum Pancha Vaktram. And this Prabhu has got now five mouths. Everything is strange. Instead of two eyes, he got three eyes. Instead of one mouth, he got five mouths. What? But you see here, we don't see any five here. Bhagavan Shiva's one name is Panchanana also. Same meaning. But Pancha Vaktra, what is Vaktra? Vaktra means mouth, that is translation if you see. But the derivation is like Vakti Anena Iti Vaktram. Vachadhatu is there. That means that by which one speaks, that is called mouth. See, very word Vaktram itself tells its meaning. So it's a mouth by which we speak. We say he's our mouthpiece. He's spokesman. Kamal Mukha, Rama Bhajana Kodya. This Mukha is given to you for Ram Bhajan. So the Mukha is very interesting, by which we speak, by which we eat also. But the Vaktra also means face. See, generally mouth means only this much you'll understand. But face means here, the kapala, the forehead is there, eyes, nose, cheeks, the chin, all this put together, even the ear, that is called a face. People are very fond of their Facebook. They are very fond of their face. But those who see only this face, they live only on surface. Superficial kind of that. But here, Pancha Vaktram. Now we have seen the five, what are five mouths? And five faces, means five aspects. Right? And next shloka, again this Pancha Vaktra also is there. So here, what is the Pancha Vaktra we'll see tomorrow? And again the Pancha Vaktra that is there, we'll see. So one meaning is that by which we speak, that's called mouth, and also means face. Or the face value, prima facie, the legal language and all that. As you just look at it, whole face. So what else we see? It is very interesting. So we'll see. There is no hurry for us. Only haraha. Om Namah Shivaya, 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 Om Namah Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya, Om Namah Shivaya, Om Namah Shivaya, Om Namah Shivaya. Har Har Namah Parvati Pataye Har Har Mahadeva. Shri Sadguru Nath Maharaj Ki Jai. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate. पूर्णस्य पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते. ओम शांति शांति शांति. हरि ओम श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः. हरि ओम.
Krishna was still there. He saw Krishna and he started chasing Krishna. Krishna was swimming fast. And as though Krishna was saying, catch me if you can. And he was going, doing. He was swimming and going. The Guru told disciple Krishna and Balram. And both of them instantly got onto their chariots, went to the ocean. And when Bhagwan Shri Krishna, the Lord of the universe, stood in front of the ocean, the Lord of the waters came up and greeted Krishna. You know what Krishna did? He photocopied himself. Krishna, Krishna.